Things happen around us to teach us lessons. There is one really funny bag in our community in Ilorin, himself and the first son. They at least saw eye to eye. To the level that that man would not even enter the father's main house where he was living. So the day the man died, this brother just took Ilorin. You know Ilorin now. It's been cloth now. There was one car, Baba put there permanently. Nobody used, especially that fellow. No, my father must not even go near it. He said, open the garage, keep the vehicle and throw it out. You now know the Owasi Pawambali. His stepmother, that one is so also very wealthy, had built her big own big house and moved there. The first factor at all was anyway, but by Dogu, everybody was in the lady. Are you getting the point? The poor man had been living in a house for more than 20 years old. He now decreed anybody who wanted to inherit must come back and live in this house with us here. The woman had to move back. Thirdly, until we go back to the era of public declaration of assets in Nigeria, many of our leaders will be incubating Wayo and Jibiti for us. And I tell people, I've challenged many of these public officials. Say, look, once you come into the public glare, you have no more secret in life. A good leader should have no secret from followers. Before, your life is like the mid-page of a size book. I'm aware, by saying this, I'm also aware that many of our public officials do what I call anticipatory declaration of assets. A man who has only 20,000 naira at the time of assumption of office will deliberately inflate what he has in the declaration forms that he has 200 million in expectation of legal acquisition of other things to make up the gap. I'm aware they didn't do that though. I'm aware they do it. But at least let people declare publicly, those who can challenge them will challenge them. And that also shows we must not be launderers for people. As Muslims, don't allow people to use your conduit pipe. Like the act between you and 60% of our money, you take the loan. And don't tell me if you don't do it, you know, what will I be eating? Say, follow on me. Say, follow on me. If Allah will assist us, he will assist all of you. Once you understand what you are doing and you stand firm, my friends there know. They know who my parents are. They are still alive. They know they are very poor people. Really poor. Like the most of our parents. And people also know that I don't do any club apart from IWF and things like this, that's all. But in spite of it, that you don't know anybody except Allah. You are doing this for this governor, you are doing for this. I don't know any of them. I'll just sit down, you call me. I don't belong to any club. I don't do anything outside of Islam. And they'll come. Sometime outside of Nigeria, they will come. Because maybe Allah is just trying to use some as examples for others to encourage people. So if Allah could do it for us, he will do it for you. Once you stand and you understand what you are doing, and you do, I'm standing here with Allah, Allah will support you. And like I always tell our children, they are standing on the shoulders of others. It's complimenting to say you are an apata, apata, atapata, didi. You are lucky. came from Erofor. You see, because for Amapata, once they slap you, you start running. Nothing holds you. But if you are starting from Erofor, as you put one foot out, the other one is stuck. I've said it elsewhere and I'm going to repeat it. All the anti-corruption laws, there must be clauses for tracing. And I will explain what I mean. A man was a governor. You said he admitted public treasury. You only hold him. Part of this money he has given to the wife. His children who are not working are using the best cars in town. Not talk of the legions of cocoa bikes, known and unknown. There must be something in our law that says that if you are convicted for corruption, the public must have access to your the assets of your immediate family. Your wife, wives, husbands, children, nieces, nephews, so that they will marry their income to their own assets as well. Once it's in excess, they must not have used them as conduit pipe. And they should forfeit all those things to the state. Because a man who will steal 200 million, he returns 50 million. He goes to jail for 1.5 months. He comes back to enjoy the balance of the 150. Where is the justice in that? So we must do that under our law to ensure that the proceeds of corruption is taken from the man and those who are including his friend, also investigate the friend. If it is Abu Salam, investigate me too. Since you know we are close, to be able to determine all my assets, are they commensurate with my income over a period of time? Then this one is going to some contractors to be annoyed here, but I don't mind. In other countries of the world, there's always forfeiture clauses in contracts. Especially in the US. Well, if you are a public contractor and it is shown that you have bribed or given gratification to public officials in order to secure contracts, you lose, it will be in the contract that once you do that, you are not only going to lose the contract, usually you'll be fined 10 times the worth of the contract. Because it's important. Contract is the greatest danger from which neglects are being swindled by their leaders. So this is also very important. Now, our brothers in the security forces, now, I've said this before, and I'm still going to repeat it. In Saudi, even in China, if you are convicted of corruption, they send you back to your creator. Because you are a menace. To allow you to live with. So I've always been saying it, until Nigerians who are found corrupt by the courts are executed. It's very important because corruption has killed all of us by installment. Some people came yesterday to come and pick some of the people with whom I traveled. They said they spent 4.5 hours on express, what an unpredictable, but express. Nigeria is one of the very few places in the world that I know where that can happen. Why is it impossible for our government to ensure that that place is free? Corruption. Corruption. Because those who are supposed to give that order and implement it, they all go there to now go and kneel down. And corruption is not taking money alone. Once you neglect to do your official duties because of extreme criminal factors. It's a form of corruption. So I'm sorry, but I join the club of those who say if you are corrupt, you are found guilty, you should be killed. So that at least that disease will be exterminated as far as you are concerned. Even if there is no tracing, people who do it will know that they are not going to live to enjoy the fruit of the corruption. That their wives can be enjoying it is your problem. So how many of us want to do that if you know that you are going to be killed and then somebody else will be enjoying the money? People will say, no, no, please, better be able to be out there. People ask immunity clause in the constitution. Yes. Those officials listed there, the 98 of them, they need immunity from ordinary courses of the court to perform well. But I've said it as well. Corruption should not be one of the things for which a governor, president, vice president, or deputy governor will be immune. Once it is an act of corruption that is proven, it should be a ground to proceed you against you, even whether you are in office or not. So I believe that the immunity clause must have a proviso. Then an important thing we must do, and our brothers who are in government and so on and so forth, this is very important for them. The bureaucracy around government and governance is so much that it promotes corruption. The labyrinth of officialdom, let's say you want to apply for COO. The level of officials who will deal with the files, there are so many that they can create bottleneck in order to extort money, and that's what happens actually in practice. So if you simplify the method by which people get public services, you eliminate corruption. For example, you can do it by putting time lag determinations on issues. You want COO. Except you drop dead, there must be a regulation. A file from the AEO, assistant executive officer, must not stay more than 48 hours on his table. The next officer. So by the time you apply for COO, you have a fair idea that within a month, the thing will come out. So you don't need to push anything. And once you don't push, there is no opportunity for giving bribe. So it's important that we must simplify the way the members of public access public services. Services rendered by any arm of government. Let's simplify them so that even the most illiterate person from the remotest part of Nigeria knows that if I apply for the driver's license and I follow the procedure, within 2 weeks I will have it. You don't need to know anybody. If you want a piece of land, you don't need to know Omeke Azandayas, because he's a surveyor. Oh, except you see him. Is that those things breed corruption? Because if you don't know him, you have to go and look for somebody else who will take money. So, Dr. Lawal, please, especially in your bursary, that is the most corrupt area of most of our institutions, bursary. If somebody has delivered services, goods, No. You must pay. So it's the same thing. The bursary department of our higher institutions is the thing about works and bursary. They are the most endemic areas of corruption in the higher institutions in Nigeria. Why do you buy admission for your children? Why? You are teaching them to be mentally indolent. Tell you why you are with it. You go and buy admission for your children. And Muslim. I don't want to talk of people buying scripts for their children to I don't even want to believe a Muslim will ever think about that. And all of the one example, no, I'm not sure of what he was. And you need that in the act of a photo. You don't need to. All of the example, you have a very old that in the act of a bar. They are just vehicles. They are just vehicles, conduit pipe to bring these children to the world. With minimum effort, come on, so don't go to the extreme of committing illegality because of them. It's not necessary. Now, there's a new theory I've been telling people, and people are laughing at me. I said, anybody who is serious about fighting corruption in Nigeria, if you have ever held public office before, the first duty for us to be sure that you are serious about the fight against corruption is for you to come into the open with all your assets and liabilities. Then, anyone you are unable to account for, as a result of your own sweat, voluntarily surrender them and forfeit them to the state. That is the time you are sure the leaders are serious to fight corruption. Somebody cannot be incubating illegally acquired property, and you think that he will be genuinely committed to any fight against corruption. It can't be done. Lawyers have something they call nemo dat, non curae habet. You don't give what you don't have. You cannot give what you don't have. You don't have good morals. How do you bestow it on other people? It's not possible. So for serious people who are serious about fighting corruption in this country, and they are public officials, they must first of all sanitize themselves, purge themselves of their own corruption. And the only way they can do it is, look, I found that out of my 15 cars, I only work for 5. So this 10, I'm giving to the Nigerian state. This time, I'm giving to X state, which is my state, where you look at the money. Then thereafter, people will know that you are serious for war. Because to fight corruption in Nigeria is war by other means. The 10th point in other serious societies, you have people you call whistleblowers. These are people, publicly spirited individuals or groups. When they see somebody and legally acquire something, they go to the authorities and blow the whistle. But there are laws that must protect them. There are laws, you must put laws in place that will protect the whistleblowers. If you want the truth, you must protect people who are ready to come and reveal the truth. That cannot happen except we have laws in place, because Nigeria is one country where the average Nigerian is afraid to report anything to the police, because sooner than later, the victim will become the accused. Most of the accidents that occur on our roads with fatal consequences, it wasn't like that before when we were younger. If you were driving and you came across an accident fresh, you will stop, assist people, put them in your vehicle, drive them to the hospital. How many Nigerians can do that now? Because if you are unfortunate, the guy dies or passes off in your vehicle, you become an suddenly you just become a guest of the police. And nobody goes to the police station without bribing himself out. This is something I know, so it's not, and I'm never afraid to say it. When Nuhu was a chairman of EFCC, either witty or witty, he invited him to go and give a lecture in their school. And I told him, I said, I'm not here for, how did I put it? When I was having the lecture, I said, I'm not here in competition for public adulation with anybody. The opinions I'm going to express here are going to be very unpopular, so I'm not expecting people to clap for me. But I'll say my mind. Midway in the lecture, he got up and ran into his office. So, we must have whistleblowers, people who can then tell you, come. X and Y said, when he was becoming governor, he had one rickety vehicle. 2 years into his tenure, we now know he has house here, there, there. Such people must be protected by law, so that people will have the confidence to come out and say, this is what we know. I've had occasion to say this to my friends in the 4th estate of Durham. If the Nigerian press is serious about fighting corruption today, corruption will gradually be eradicated in Nigeria. Sugar, Olete, Olega. Some journalists came to interview me one day. I now told him, I said, are you bad, yeah? Oh, in that job. Once you knew, oh, in that job, would you need can? Any of you who put that, my man, I'm not looking at you. Well, I'm not going to tell you, man. You don't come from here. I said, you are from XY news media. I said, yes. I said, have you ever sat down to ask where your dad got the money to establish this as this place? Because I know from my stupid economics that to establish a printing press, a national newspaper in Nigeria today, minimally, you have no money, you must invest minimum of between 2 to 2-3 billion naira. Oh, yes. And somebody is a governor or was a governor, had national newspapers. Did we ask questions? Are we asking questions? We must say the truth. Most, and I say it with emphasis, most people that become religious godfathers and today in Nigeria, they are rogues and crooks. And until we take our such life and look at the iron sheets all over the place, there will be one more. We'll make progress. That's the truth. If somebody establishes a national newspaper in Nigeria, let him tell you all his earnings in his life, legitimate earnings. How he was able to come about 2 billion to establish a newspaper organization or a television station. So the Nigerian press has a central role. It's more than crucial. If you consider the issue of corruption as a circle, they are like the nucleus, they are in the middle. The day the Nigerian press is ready to do battle with corruption, we will succeed. Because I don't know what they are. I don't know what they are. All these Baba Lele Baba Ken. The affiliations of the newspapers and the press. Let's ask critical questions. It's very important. Because the lady, when you go your my own theory is that the president, vice president, governors and deputy governors, they teach the people more. They cannot be the originator of this massive corruption that is on ground. It's not, it's beyond them. And Nigerians, especially Nigerian press, suffers from self-induced amnesia, loss of memory. All those who are labeled as criminals and money launderers are today the political leaders of this country. All past presidents attacked my wife, said, past. Catch all of them were charged with corruption before. Including the person who was really appointed for something else. What happened to their cases? Is that, that's the work of the press. They are the people who should be screwing this on. Say, look, there are social time. You see how they case. So please, through you, we are appealing to you people, please assist us. The Nigerian Bar Association. I'm moving up. I've left the press. Nigerian Bar Association, Nigerian Society of Engineers, and Nigerian Institution of Surveyors, and Nigerian Institute of Chartered Accountants. Nigerian Institute of Bankers. If you cannot achieve anything within these professional bodies, let people know you that you don't tolerate anything that. And incidentally, all these professions have their rules of ethics, which prohibit all these things. Oh, but most of us believe that except we also bend corners and cut corners, we are not going to make it. No, you don't need to. Let your colleagues also recognize you as somebody who is not compromising when it comes to issue of probity. Initially, people will tell you all sorts of things, but as time goes on, like I said at the beginning, I know the Nigerians is so interesting. You know, people will now tell you, you know, I'm going to law. So when the man sometimes I mean, like anybody who knew me, I started this lawyer job on the salary of 300 naira. And that was on the salary on which I got married. But the truth is that anybody who knows me, those who knew me from when we were all boys, they knew, you knew ourselves. People will tell you, I've always been like this. So when people tell me something, I was appointed as chairman of Office of Public Defenders in Kwara by the governor. And so we were having meetings, and I told them. The first thing I told the members, I said, come, luckily, go away, go to this is a board appointment. I said, can you be come out and do a professional movie? Take me back, go. That's what destroys most public institutions. Part-time members of board, they become permanent. They will now create offices for them in the meaning in the place. It's wrong. And I said, secondly, they said they will be giving us monthly stipend. And I said, I'll talk to the government. That is wrong. That's the drain of public funds. We are part-time people, we are not entitled to salaries, but sitting allowance. Why should they be paying our salaries? No. Of course, I didn't end up telling the governor. You know why? There was another sister body headed by our former CJ. I said, okay. Thirdly, we were inaugurated in April or May of a particular year. When we were going to pay the first money, they brought money for the month we were inaugurated and the month before. And I said, ah, maybe I didn't. He said, I said, no. I said, which law? And I told our own members, I said, look, before we were inaugurated, did you have right to come to this place to say you are holding meetings? They said, no. So why should you get paid for that period? Why? They came to me and said, oh, so I said, in any event, I don't want to land yet. One of the here. Me, I didn't collect for that month. All others, the other sisters of the all collected, which is okay. And I told our director, I said, pay the money to Treasury, give me a receipt. Oh, what you do, Raleigh? You call you, and you attest to it, Abby? Thank you. What you back to Raleigh? You call you? One is to the valley, a galletti, there's some book and colour. So if you have a level, it's a guy here. But for Nico, it won't work. So we must all accept that just on your own. Don't the work of being honest. I always tell people, honesty, you cannot acquire data in life. It's either you have it or forget it. You can't acquire honesty data in life. It's almost impossible. Is that you are honest, transparent, incorruptible, or you are not? Physician, heal thyself. I've always formed the impression.